Racing to the 2022 Kentucky Derby, and this time we go to Churchill Downs for the Grade 1 Kentucky Derby, and we're going to be talking about this 20-horse field. Of course, the race is a Grade 1, which is the most top-class race that we have in the United States. It is 10 furlongs, a mile and a quarter, and they are going to be all carrying 126 pounds. It's going to be the first Saturday in May. And that means that Churchill Downs 20 horses will be thundering down the stretch, and we're going to find out who is the best three-year-old in America. Let's take a look at the field, starting with post positions 1 through 10. Mo Donegal comes in off a big win in the Wood Memorial. He has the highest Brisnet speed figure of 111. He's trained by Todd Pletcher. He draws the rail. Happy Jack is a long shot. He has lost three straight races by over 10 lengths. Doug O'Neill trains. He's a two-time Kentucky Derby winner. Epicenter, the most likely favorite, going to be one of the co-favorites. Zandon was made the morning line favorite at 3-1. Epicenter at 7-2. This puts him with no excuses. Epicenter, I expect him to be on the lead, drawing that three post position. Meanwhile, Summer is Tomorrow. Speed from the UAE Derby. He's going to try to add some fuel to the fire. He does have a good race at a mile and 3/16, but he's going to have to carry that an extra 16th of a mile. Smile Happy had two big wins as a two-year-old. He's yet to win at 3 years old. He's faced Epicenter and Zandon. Now he tries to get on the winning end here in the Kentucky Derby. Messier had lost twice as the favorite, the LaSalle Futurity, and also he lost in the Santa Anita Derby. Messier, can he come from off the pace for his best chance to win? Crown Pride is the UAE Derby winner. He had 2 1/8 races in Japan. He's 3-4 lifetime with a 46 2/5 workout last week. Charge It is trained by Todd Pletcher. Broke his maiden by 8 lengths, came back and ran second in a Grade 1 stakes race. Meanwhile, Tis the Bomb goes for Ken McPeak. Synthetic to dirt, he's got some class. Was awarded the victory last year in the Breeders' Cup on the tote board anyways. Meanwhile, he finished second in the race. And then Zandon, trained by Chad Brown. He's 0-6 in the Kentucky Derby. Ran second with Good Magic. Also had a nice top 5 finish with Practical Joke and Normandy Invasion. Zandon should be able to set up shop in the middle of the track with Flavian Pratt. Post position number 11, Pioneer of Medina, trained by Todd Pletcher, has lost two straight to Epicenter after winning two straight on the lead. His best chance may be on or near the lead with Epicenter in this race. Taba is trying to overcome the curse of Leonatus, trying to win the Derby for the first time and since the 1800s in his third lifetime race. Simplification. His two best races, speed figure-wise, he won by 16 lengths in the maiden race, a 109.3. He went wire to wire in the Mucho Macho Man. Coming from off the pace, he's ran slower. Will he be near the lead? He drew post position 13. Barber Road has lower speed figures than most of the top contenders. White Abario, 4 wins at Gulfstream Park, ran third at Churchill Downs as a two-year-old, sharp recent works. Cyberknife, the Arkansas Derby winner, trained by Brad Cox, back-to-back wins, big speed figure on the undercard of the Risen Star. He ran just as fast as Epicenter did that day. Classic Causeway is speed from the outside. He's your Tampa Bay Derby winner and your Sam F. Davis winner. Tawnyport goes for Brad Cox. He's got 3 runners in this race. He's a stretch runner, won the Lexington Stakes in his most recent race. Zozos, the Pride of Minnesota, drew the 19th post position. Last time out, he ran second on the lead, lost to Epicenter. With that 19th post position, does he come from off the pace and try to make a mid-race move like he did in his 10-length win at Oaklawn Park? And the coach, Dwayne Lucas, starts his 50th Kentucky Derby starter, gets the outside draw, 20th post position, 4th in the Lexington, ran second in the Rebel Stakes, and it's a solid 20-horse field for the Kentucky Derby. The point leaders are Epicenter, Zandon, White Abario, and Mo Donegal. Epicenter, of course, drawing post position 3, and you've also got Cyberknife in post position 16. Crown Pride draws post position number 7. The grade one winners are White Abario, Taba, and Zandon. They are the class of the race. The only other grade one winner as a two-year-old in the Breeders' Cup, you had Corniche. He did not make it to the Kentucky Derby. Multiple stakes winners. We've got Tis the Bomb, Epicenter, and Mo Donegal. Of course, Tis the Bomb winning a couple of stakes races at Turfway Park on the synthetic. Epicenter winning three stakes races at Louisiana. He won the Gunrunner Stakes, the Louisiana Derby, and also the Risen Star. His best races have been on the lead at the stretch call, and he likes to be up by multiple lengths, and he took advantage of that winning those races. Mo Donegal, he's a closer. He won the Remsen as a two-year-old. He won the Wood Memorial as a three-year-old. Now, Mo Donegal, he's got the highest Brisnet speed figure. That was a 111, and he did it coming from behind, coming from off the pace, chasing down the lone speed in that race. Taba, can he overcome the curse of Leonatus? He's got good pedigree, was purchased for $1.7 million as a two-year-old. It's only his third lifetime race, trained by Tim Yakteen, formerly Bob Baffert. Now we've got the big three. Smile Happy, Big Hopes, coming into the three-year-old year, has not won yet. Simplification, big wins in a 6-furlong race, won by 16 lengths, won the Mucho Macho Man, was second in the Fountain of Youth, and then ended up running third in the Florida Derby. Meanwhile, you've got Cyberknife, back-to-back wins. He's got six lifetime races, and he does got some good two-year-old experience to go back on for some racing experience here. He seems to be training well, a nice 6-furlong workout last week. Messier, he's going to be facing a big field. He's been on the lead in the small fields out west at California, but now he's got to face a 20-horse field. His best chance may be to come from off the pace. Now, the most competitive preps were the Risen Star. It featured Smile Happy, Zandon, and also Epicenter, who came back to win the Louisiana Derby. Then you've got the Bluegrass with Zandon, who finished first, and then Smile Happy, who came in to 2022 as the Kentucky Derby future book favorite, even though he's lost two races this year. And then the Florida Derby, White Abario, just keeps on winning. Simplification, a proven stakes horse, and then Charge It, a great pedigree, trained by Todd Pletcher. Now, pace makes the race. Here's how I see it at the 4-furlong call, right where the arrow is down the backstretch. I see Simplification, Classic Causeway, and Epicenter battling for the lead. Epicenter drew inside of those three horses. Meanwhile, at the 7-furlong mark, this is where it's going to get interesting. As you round that second turn, you're going to see Epicenter, Simplification, and possibly Messier battling for the lead. I still think it might be Epicenter in front. And then you've got the big three making their moves. Smile Happy, White Abario, and Zandon. And how that sets up between those six horses could determine who takes the lead coming into the stretch. Now, the closers, you've got a few horses that could possibly close in this race, including Mo Donegal, who had a big close the last time. Mo Donegal, Tis the Bomb, and Smile Happy, I think, are one-run closers. They're going to try to get clear and then try to make a sustained long run to that leader, which most likely will be Epicenter or Simplification, possibly Messier, and maybe even Classic Causeway for the first 6 furlongs. Now, the top contenders are Epicenter, Mo Donegal, Zandon, White Abario, Cyberknife, Tis the Bomb. They were all winners of their prep races, and then you had Simplification, who is also a proven stakes performer. I think the three horses improving the most are Zandon right now for only 4 lifetime races, a big win in the Bluegrass, Mo Donegal, a win as a two-year-old, and a win in the Wood Memorial, and then White Abario, 4 wins at Gulfstream Park. My selection for the 2022 Kentucky Derby, Epicenter's a good horse. White Abario, nothing wrong with him. I also think you can make a very strong case for Zandon. My top selection, again, we've got some videos up on speed figures, pace ratings, late pace ratings. My selection is going to be Mo Donegal. He drew the one post position. I liked his Wood Memorial. He came home in under 24 seconds. He's got a distance pedigree, gets Irad Ortiz. He's got a win as a two-year-old. He built up that foundation in the Remsen, and then he's coming off a big win, a big speed figure by Brisnet scale, and a final quarter in sub 24 seconds. I'm going to play him in exactas over Zandon, White Abario, Simplification, and Epicenter. Again, hope you've enjoyed these videos. Hope this kind of, you know, the videos are made for you to kind of do your handicapping, take a look at some of my notes, hopefully with some of your notes. But my top selection is going to be Mo Donegal. If you like to play long shots, my long shot winner is Tis the Bomb. This guy's got back-to-back wins, a big speed figure, and he can come from off the pace and come smoking down the lane. Don't forget, Tuesday night, 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central, we're going to study up for the Kentucky Derby, work on some betting tickets, and get some questions from you, the listener. Make sure to watch Tuesday night, 7 o'clock Central. Who do you like in the Kentucky Derby? Remember, the best way to support the channel, hit the like button, share this with other people, horse racing fans, and hit that thanks button as we lead you up to the first Saturday in May.